Hello, I am Seamus Dunhu of Eve University, and this is a guide to planetary interaction. This guide replaces an older guide originally by Turhan Bey, also of Eve University, which references game mechanic details that have since been significantly changed. This guide is current as of the Incarna expansion. Planetary interaction is about establishing a colony on a planet and having it manufacture resources for you, which you can then use in various industrial purposes or sell on the market to players who will use those materials for various industrial purposes. If you want to get started on planetary interaction, the first thing we need to look at are the skills required for it. So let's go to Neocom, Character Sheet, and you want to look under the Planet Management section. Oh, by the way, you'll want to go to the Settings tab, make sure Show All Skills is turned on, then go back to the Skills tab. And the first one you will start off with is Remote Sensing. And once you have Remote Sensing, let's see, Remote Sensing only has Science Level 3 as a prerequisite, which I think you might already start off with as a new player, I don't remember. But train Science up to Level 3 if you don't have that already. So get Remote Sensing first. And you can then get Planetology once you have Remote Sensing Level 3. And what Remote Sensing does is that it allows you to scan a planet for resources. So I'm in the Madir Malire solar system. Let me left-click the menu icon here, and let me go to Show Info on Madir Malire 3. By the way, if you look at the Attributes tab on the Show Info for a planet, every planet has a radius in kilometers. I'll explain the significance of the planet's radius later, but generally speaking, all other factors being equal, you want a smaller planet rather than a larger one. So let's left-click the menu icon and view in planet mode. And here, we can see Madir Malire 3. Now, by default, you're looking at the Build tab right here, which isn't relevant yet because we're not ready to build anything. Let's click on Scan first. Now, every planet type has 5 different kinds of raw materials. For barren planets, such as Madir Malire 3, those are always aqueous liquids, base metals, carbon compounds, microorganisms, and noble metals. And you can click any one of these 5 to take a look at a heat map, which represents the concentration levels of that resource on the planet. And you can left-click and drag to look at different parts of the planet. White color indicates highest concentrations, and the absence of a color indicates lowest concentrations. And you can adjust the exact meanings of these colors by adjusting sliders here on this scale. So in the grand scheme of things, this planet doesn't have quite a lot of resources, but it's pretty good for a high security planet. Let me adjust this back downwards until I can start seeing splotches of white somewhere. There we go. So you can adjust the maximum on the heat map, you can also adjust the minimum on the heat map, so that you can ignore very low concentration areas if you are so inclined. I just like to keep the minimum at 0 and adjust the maximum as I need it. A word of warning, there are sometimes hotspots on planets. These are only temporary hotspots, where the concentrations of resources are much higher than anywhere else. You don't want to do your colony planning based on the hotspots, because that hotspot won't always be there. As a matter of fact, chances are it's almost guaranteed to be gone in a week's time. What you want to look at are the general tendencies for that resource on the planet. Now here, carbon compounds are in splotches pretty much all over the place. If we look at base metals, that's also splotches, aqueous liquids, that's more in the polar regions. Noble metals are in splotches all over the place. You know what, let me show you a better example of this. Let's go to Madir Malire 6 and view that in planet mode. This is a gas giant, and if I look at the different raw materials here, aqueous liquids are concentrated in two bands in the northern and southern hemispheres of the planet. Base metals around the equator. Reactive gas. Hold on. Reactive gases and splotches all over the place. Noble gas. Noble gas is in the same bands as, I think it was the aqueous liquids, I'm not sure. Ionic solutions are concentrated in the polar regions. So when planning your colony, you want to plan based upon the general tendencies and what it is that you want to extract, not just upon the hotspots. Now you might be wondering how to determine which materials to extract, what would be profitable, what do you need? Well, unless you're if you're an industrialist who has particular need for the materials in question, that makes the solution rather easy. For example, if you are helping to run star bases for your corporation or alliance, star bases need a material called coolant. And to make coolant, you need water and electrolytes, but to make water and electrolytes, you need aqueous liquids and ionic solutions. So, here are your ionic solutions. Here are your aqueous liquids. So you might place a colony somewhere around here so that you have easy reach to both of those things, and you can make coolant on a single planet. If you're making stuff for profit, then you'll want to go to the market, browse tab, make sure the range filter's on region, show only available is ticked off, go to manufacture and research, materials, planetary materials, and usually you don't want to sell just raw materials, although some people seem to be trying to do... Oh, I finished my battleship, how nice. Some people seem to try to sell raw materials on the market. Raw materials take up a lot of volume. You're better off processing it into processed materials first, and then exporting it off your planet and selling the processed materials on the market. So you can take a look at the market for processed materials, and you can see what sells well, what doesn't. And based upon the prices, you can then go back and take a look at the planet in question. By the way, the Eve University Wiki has, wiki.eveuniversity.org. The Eve University Wiki has a lot of reference material on the subject of planetary interaction. In particular, you can look up the link for planetary commodities, and you can look at the information on the production chains for the various planetary materials. So the Eve University Wiki is a good reference source for that. So between the wiki and the market data, you can make a decision as to what kinds of raw materials you want to extract and process. And based on the choice of raw materials, you can decide what sort of planet you want to colonize. I'm not going to actually do that. I'm just going to decide, I'll go with a small planet, and you know what? I'll make it a barren planet. So, Madir Malire 3, and just because this bar is kind of high, I'm going to go with microorganisms. So I'm looking at the heat map for microorganisms. Now, I happen to be in the solar system, so I can always left-click the menu icon here and go to planets and pick a planet to view in planet mode. Let me right click and exit planet mode for a moment. If I'm not in the solar system and I want to scan a planet, by the way, a useful thing to have your star map set to. By default, it's usually showing security status, but you can go to the let me do this one step at a time. Neocom. Map, the world map control panel, the star map tab, the stars subtab, go to the my information folder, and planet scan range. Now remember from the wording of the remote sensing skill. It allows you to scan planets, but it also allows you to scan planets at distance, that distance given in light years. And when you look at the planet's scan range, you can see how far solar systems are away from you in light years. So that's 4.3 light years away, that is 6.3 light years away, and that solar system is outside my scan range, so I can't scan any of the planets there. If I try, it just... That's strange. I thought it would have thrown an error message at me by now. Here you go. At your remote sensing skill level, you can only scan planets closer than 7 light years. This is 7.8 something. Let me go back to the map. So you can pick a solar system, right-click the solar system, show info, go to the orbital bodies tab, and you can right-click a planet and view in planet mode. You might want to show info on the planet first, because you'll want to know the radius. 4,230 kilometers in the case of Gosalav 3. And then you can start scanning for resources. Word of warning, the heat maps can be inaccurate. They can lie to you. If you want your heat maps to be more accurate, you will want to increase your skill levels in planetology and advanced planetology, and I think remote sensing might also play a role in this, because planetary scans are more accurate if you're in the solar system than if you're 5 or 6 or 7 light years away from the solar system. So this heat map will change if I actually go to the Gosalav solar system and run the scan again. But I'm not interested in Gosalav, I'm interested in Magirulary 3, so let me go back to that. So I have, for some odd reason, decided that I want to extract microorganisms and I want to process them into bacteria and sell bacteria on the market, so I'm going to use a barren planet for that purpose. That decision being made, I am going to go to the market. Let me close manufacturing research and let me go to planetary infrastructure. Command centers. There are different kinds of command centers. It's very important that you purchase the correct kind for the planet you want to colonize. If I grab an oceanic command center, that will be completely useless when I'm looking at a barren planet. So left click barren command center and look for NPCs that are selling this thing. Remember that NPC buy and sell orders have an expiry time of 364 days. Player buy and sell orders are 90 days or less. Some players have purchased command centers at the NPC price, taken them to the trade hub in Amar, and are reselling them in Amar for a slightly higher price. And other players will probably buy these here in Amar because they may need to be doing one-stop shopping, and they don't want to go hunting around for the NPC sellers. But I happen to be docked in a station where NPCs are selling this thing. So I'm going to right-click, buy this, and click buy. And I'll close this. Something to keep in mind, these command centers are 1,000 cubic meters. Generally, you're going to want to use an industrial to move this thing around. If necessary, you could try to use a Tech 1 cruiser instead, but not all Tech 1 cruisers can be fit with modules to increase the cargo's capacity enough. The Caldari Osprey, the Minmatar Rupture, the Galente Vexer, the Galente Execrer, and any of the Tech 1 Amarian cruisers except the Arbitrator have a good combination of cargo capacity and low slot modules into which you could stick expanded cargo holds Tech 2. So those cruisers you can expand to 1,000 cubic meters. But generally you'll want to use an industrial. So I happen to have an industrial with me. So I am going to, where are my ships? Open up my cargo hold, and I will drag the command center into the cargo hold. Close the cargo hold, close my station item hangar, and I'm going to undock. Now that I am in space, the first thing I am going to do, I'm going to right-click the station and I'm going to orbit it at current distance, because I don't want to actually leave the vicinity of the station. I don't need to. To colonize a planet, you must be in space, in the same solar system as the planet, and have the command center in your cargo hold. So I want to colonize Madir Milliray 3. That means I need to be in space in the Madir Milliray solar system. I cannot do this while docked, and I think I cannot do this while cloaked, though I would have to double check that later. So now that I'm in space, I'm going to go to my pod saver tab, because that's where I keep my planets. I'm going to right-click Madir Milliray 3. I'm going to view in planet mode. Let me go to the scan again. I want to double-check the locations of microorganisms. And they're concentrated in two general bands. For now, I will build my colony near one of the hotspots, though, like I said, that hotspot may not be there by next week. But this hotspot is in the middle of one of the general bands that I can find microorganisms. I'll go to the Build tab, click Command Centers, click Bearing Command Center, aim my command center right there, left click. Let me use my mouse wheel to scroll in. And when I am... this is just a planned change, it hasn't happened yet. I have to click Submit. There we go. Now if you left click on the command center, you've only got 1675 teraflops of CPU and 6000 megawatts of power grid. The command center provides the resources that the rest of your colony needs to operate. You want to put launch pads, you want to put extractors, you want to put processors, you want to link them together so you can move stuff back and forth between your facilities. Those all take central processing unit and power grid. And if you don't have enough of either, you can't expand your facility any further. You'd have to decommission some facilities to build others. By the way, if we're going back to the skills again, that's where Command Center Upgrades comes in. Now I have Command Center Upgrades up to level 2, so what I'm going to do, click the Upgrade button, left click here, and click Upgrade. All right. Now I have 12,000 teraflops and 12,000 megawatts to play with. Now, first order of business, I'm going to build a launch pad, right, a spaceport, and I'm going to put it right next to the command center. The next thing I want to do, I want to extract stuff. So let me grab an extractor control unit, and the extractor control unit will present you with a circle indicating how far away it can place its extractor heads, which I'll explain in a moment. But for now, let's just put the extractor control unit next to the... actually, you know what? Just as a demonstration of what's more common, let me put the extractor control unit over here, and we're going to pretend that this hotspot were actually further away from the launch pad than it really is. Now, what I need to do is I need to link the extractor control unit to the launch pad. The launch pad serves two purposes. It allows you to import and export stuff to and from your planet. But it also has this internal storage, 10,000 cubic meters, so this doubles as a storage facility. So you're going to control left click one of these things, let go of the control key, and then left click the other thing, and that will establish a link between the two. Again, these are all planned changes, indicating as yellow or orange highlights on these structures. So these changes haven't happened yet. If you want these changes to actually happen, then you need to click the Submit button, and the game will tell you what ISK cost to expect. So this will take me about 2.5 million ISK. So I'm going to click Submit. Now I have the extractor control unit. You do need to have this built. You need to place it and submit the change before you can actually do what's called a survey. So having left-clicked the extractor control unit, I'm going to left-click Survey. And here I'm going to click Microorganisms here on the right hand side of the panel, and I am going to install You know what? Let me put 7 extractor heads. When you click and drag these extractor heads, you can see a general index on how good a spot that is for extracting resources. And as you drag it around, it'll change sound. Very poor, better, better, and better. So it's accompanied by a sound in addition to the heat map that you have. Again, though, the heat map can lie to you. I think these raw output quality indices here might be more reliable. Now, if I leave this as is, it will extract materials for 1 hour, and then it'll stop and wait for more orders. I can change the duration of this program. So if I change this slider and I move it around, the program will last for longer and it'll be a greater total load, but it'll be less materials per unit time. So if I go with a 2-day, 14-hour program, I'll pull up a total of 868,000 microorganisms, but only 14,000 per hour. Whereas if I leave this at a 1-hour program, I'll only pull up 37,000 microorganisms, but it'll be 37,000 per hour. So ideally, you want to set the length of the program to be approximately how frequently you want to check in on your planet. Personally, I like to go with 2-day cycles, so I'm going to drag to about here, and if you want to adjust the increments, you can left-click the minus or plus boxes next to the slider bar. So that will be a 2-day program. Note that the duration of the program does affect the extraction area on your heads. Alright. And you typically don't want them overlapping, otherwise they're going to be less effective than if they weren't overlapping. So set the duration of your program first, and then put your extractor heads in position. Since I've got 70 of these things, I will put them... You know, I can barely see what I'm doing. Let me change the heat map color. There we go. Let me put these in a hexagon formation on top of this hotspot. Alright, there we go. Nice and neat. By the way, you will frequently be limited on the power grid of your command center. An extractor control unit with no extractor heads requires 2600 megawatts. And then each extractor head that you add to the extractor control unit is another 550 megawatts. So an extractor control unit with 10 heads would take, if I'm doing the math correctly in my head, 8100 megawatts. Whenever possible, you want to have fewer extractor control units and more extraction heads. Try not to have 2 extractor control units if you can help it. Size reference, at command center upgrades level 5, your command centers can have up to 19,000 megawatts. And if an extractor control unit with 10 heads is 8,100 megawatts, well, there you go. I'm sure you can do the math from there. So click the install program. Let's left-click the extractor again, because if we don't do anything else and click submit, the raw materials that it pulls up are just going to be thrown out the window and forgotten. We need to route the products somewhere. The extractor control unit does not have any internal storage. So left-click the extractor control unit, click products, double-click microorganisms, and if we try to double-click a destination, we'll notice this red number here, 244%. That route cannot be created, as adding traffic to one of the links over which it travels would create dangerous levels of congestion. Okay, just left-click on an empty spot on the planet. We need to fix this problem first. So left-click the link. If you click on stats, you'll see that it takes up a certain number of teraflops and a certain number of megawatts. This depends upon the capacity of the link and upon the distance over which it travels. If I control left-click and draw out the line again, you'll notice this is 364 kilometers, and that's going to take 65 megawatts and 88 teraflops for your basic link. By the way, this is why the radius of the planet is important. A small radius planet means that the same angular distances over the planet's surface will be fewer kilometers than on a large radius planet. If I were trying to do this on a 36,000 kilometer radius gas giant rather than a 2,600 kilometer radius barren planet, then this same link would be about 20 times more expensive on the power grid and the CPU. I wouldn't be looking at 65 megawatts and 88 teraflops, I would be looking at something closer to... a 1,000 megawatts? So yeah, it can be a serious strain on your command center. That's why you want smaller planets rather than larger. Let me right-click to cancel this. Alright. So left-click the link. We need to double this twice. So click Upgrade. Click Upgrade. Click on the link again. Click Upgrade. Click the button. Now that should have enough capacity. Click the extractor, click products, double click, and put this over the launch pad, double click. You want to route the products to a storage facility or a launch pad, something that can buffer the materials. The reason being that if you just route it directly to a processor, whatever materials the processor can't immediately take will get thrown out the window and forgotten, and you've wasted those materials. So you want to buffer it through a storage before sending it to processors. Speaking of, if we're going to turn microorganisms into bacteria, let's go to the Build tab. Let's go to Processors. Let's go to Barren Basic Indus... Hold on. How much stuff am I pulling up from this? About 20,000 an hour on average. Okay. Each basic can handle 6,000 an hour, so let's go to processors, basic industry, and I'm going to put down three of these. One, two, three. Control left click, left click, control left click, left click, control left click, left click. Remember, you have to let go of the control key before you establish the destination of the link, because if you just hold down control and keep left-clicking all over the place, it's not actually going to create any links. Alright, you have to release the control button, then left-click on the destination. But I'm going to right-click to cancel this. Now for each processor, I need to do the following. Double left-click. Look for the schematic I want. I can single left-click a schematic to see what input it needs. Biofuels, for example, is useless because I'm not pulling up carbon compounds. I want to make bacteria because that's what makes use of the microorganisms. Double left-click bacteria. It'll ask you to route the products. Double left-click the product. Double left-click the launch pad. So again, double left-click, double left-click, double left-click. Double left click. Double click. Double click. Double click. Double click. I'm almost starting to sound like a dance teacher. Alright. So yeah, it's a lot of clicking. Trust me, it was much worse when Tyrannus launched. It was a lot of single clicking. It was insane. I am very glad that CCP finally changed this. I didn't get into Planetary Interaction myself until CCP finally improve the interface. So yeah, trust me, this is an improvement over what it used to be. So we've told the processors we want them to make bacteria and where to send the bacteria, but they need input. So we have to tell the launch pad to send the inputs. Now, we can't create a route from storage because there's nothing in storage, but we can take a look at the incoming routes. It's expecting microorganisms, so single click, click create route, and double-click a processor. That arranges the input for one processor. Let's do that two more times. Single-click, 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 double click, single click, scroll down, single click, double click. Okay. And click submit. That sets up our colony. The extractor control unit is now pulling up microorganisms, which are routed to the launch pad as a storage buffer. From the launch pad, it is then routed to each of the three Baron basic industry facilities, which are set to make bacteria, and the facilities then route the bacteria back to the launch pad, again as a storage buffer. If I were going to then use the bacteria along with some other materials to manufacture something else, I would have to then route the bacteria from the launch pad to a Baron advanced industry facility. I would also have to route the other input from the launch pad to the Baron advanced industry facility, and then route the products from the advanced industry facility back to the launch pad. Remember, you want to have some form of storage buffering every single step so as not to waste materials. Alright. Now, I can't demonstrate how to export stuff from the planet because I would need to wait half an hour for this first product extraction cycle to complete, and then another half hour for these manufacturing cycles to complete before the bacteria would start showing up in the launch pad. Thankfully, though, this is my second attempt at trying to film this episode. During the first attempt, I had established a different colony on Madir Malire 2. So, let me exit planet mode. Let me right-click Madir Malire 2 and view that in planet mode. And here's my colony. So now, on this one, this one's been running for a little bit, so it's now got microorganisms and bacteria. Okay. There are two ways that I can get this stuff off the planet. Now, I established a link between the command center and the launch pad. If you don't have enough CPU or power grid for a real launch pad, you can instead use a storage facility to buffer the materials. Storage facility only has 5,000 cubic meters capacity, but it takes up much less CPU than a launch pad. The launch pad requires 3,600 teraflops. Usually your colony is not teraflop limited unless you didn't upgrade it, so typically the CPU usage is not the issue. You're usually far more limited by the power grid. But let's suppose this were an ordinary storage facility, and a storage facility can't export. So I would go to storage, I would left-click the bacteria, I would do expedited transfer, I would left-click the command center, and let's see. Can I shift left-click and drag to only move some of these? Yes, I can. So I will move 160 units to the command center. Alright. Expedited transfers will move things instantly between facilities, but it imposes a cooldown time on when you can do another expedited transfer. So I'm going to click Execute Transfer, and now the materials are in the storage of my command center. A word of warning, if you're using the command center to hold your product, it's only got 500 cubic meters. That's very small, even compared to the 5,000 cubic meters of a storage facility or the 10,000 cubic meters of a launch pad. My alt, which has level command center upgrades level 5, does not use the command center for storage. It uses a launch pad for the purpose. But if you don't have a launch pad, then the way to get stuff off of your planet is to put it in the command center. You're going to click the launch button, left-click the item to be moved. Can I drag this? No, I can't drag this. Left-click the item to be launched, add it to the payload, and then click go for launch. 3, 2, 1, contact. That empties out the command center, since I launched everything. I'm going to right-click Exit Planet Mode. Now, how do I get to it? Is it part of... No, I don't think it's part of the right-click context menu. What you do, you go to Neocom, Journal, go to the Planetary Launches tab, and here you see the payload that you launched. Now, when you launch stuff from a command center, it appears in a cargo container in space. Most cargo containers only last 2 hours from when they were created, but planetary launch containers will last 5 days. So you can get to it whenever you have time. But if you don't get to it, it's going to go through atmospheric reentry, burn up, and everything inside will be destroyed. So I have 5 days to right-click to get into the solar system, right-click, and select warp to location.
Warp drive.
I need to hurry. I only have 5 days left before that thing expires. I wonder if I'll be able to warp to it in time from within the same solar system. Let me go to my default overview tab, because I want to be able to see cargo containers. And this will be a random spot near the planet in question. Near as in I'm only 436 kilometers away from the planet's surface. And there is my planetary launch container. I left-click the container. Open cargo. By the way, for those of you who have taken a directional scanner class, you might notice that this planetary launch container can appear on the directional scan. So somebody could try to use directional scanner and try to slow boat their way over here based only on the directional scanner and a fast frigate with a micro warp drive. So if you're doing this in low security space and you leave the container sitting there for a couple of days before you go to pick it up, you might find that it's being camped by somebody who's waiting to kill you. Word of warning. So just left click and drag from the cargo container to your cargo hold, and you've picked up the launch from your command center. That's one way to do it. This does not allow you to do imports if all you've got on the planet is a bunch of factories and they need inputs from the outside. For imports or larger exports, let me go back to viewing Madir Milire 2 in planet mode. I can left click the launch pad. I can click launch, and I can left click and drag the bacteria, and click export from planet. Those materials are no longer in the launch pad. They are now in what's called a customs office. So let me exit planet mode. Let me go to my pod saver tab, because I put customs offices on my pod saver tab. Right click the customs office and warp to within 0 meters.
Warp drive active.
If a planet doesn't have a customs office, then one will be created when the first player builds a launch pad on the planet. The customs office appears automatically and for free, and all future colonies established by other players on the same planet will use the same customs office. So you warp to zero on the customs office, you can open the hangar, and this is your personal hangar in the customs office, and you can left click and drag from the hangar to your cargo hold. If you wanted to, you could also drag other materials into the spaceport hangar. Right-click the customs office, access customs office, and you can click the import or the export button. I'm going to click import, and you could left-click and drag stuff in the list to be transferred and import to the planet, so I can send these bacteria right back down to the planet if I wanted to. I don't want to do that, so I'm just going to take these out of the spaceport. Right click, view market details. Where can I sell these? I can sell this stuff in Amar for 75 ISK per unit. So if I wanted to, I could set a course for Amar and go sell this stuff. This is considerably longer than most of my other YouTube episodes, but hopefully this clears up how to do planetary interaction and set up a basic colony. Thank you for watching.